Good morning, dear viewer, on this rather cloudy 2nd of May, Sunday, 2009. News just in. Now, I can't besmirch anyone, because they get all libelous and stuff like that, but Times Online is reporting, I think it's like that, that Baroness Ubbin, Pine, whatever, right, she's done the old, they're reporting, they're saying, indicating that she's done the old houses, what? She's jumping the old gravy train with the old houses. She's got some drum next to the Commons or the House of Lords, right? And she's claiming for this, her real home. This is my real home. Yeah, she's just got bought it back a couple of years ago, though, about 3 years ago, something like that. And it's a two-bed flat in Maidstone Way. And the neighbour's saying, she doesn't live here. It's all, we haven't seen sticky furniture in there ever. You know, since she bought it. But, fortnight ago, and doorstepping them, the online people, Times Online, Times, and they asked this plumber there, and he says, oh, I think they've just moved, and they said they've just moved in. And they've put some curtains up. This is a report from Times Online. So that's a bit odd, isn't it, people? So it's about this, they're saying she's claiming 100,000 and stuff like that. And the idea is, if you live away from, if your main home is away from London, you're allowed this little, this is the idea, a little place next to, so now got all that travelling expense and all that. So they pay for your second home that is away, no, was it? They pay for your second home that is near your House of Lords, if your main home is far away and it saves all the travelling. But what they're doing is they're reversing it. They're living at, the ones that are actually living in London already, they're not getting the perk. So they're buying a drum further away and they're saying that's their main home. So they're reverse engineering it sort of thing. So it's out of order. And they're saying that's what she's up to. I mean, Baroness with a two-bed flat, does that sound right? I mean, she's got about 5 kids or something. So that's a bit odd. But now there's this video on YouTube, and it says, she's got talking about Gert Wilders, and she says, I wouldn't have this video in the dustbin in my house. House? What house? Your main home is a flat, a two-bed flat, where you stuff 5 kids in, apparently. So that's very odd, isn't it? Oh yeah, so the other night we had Frank Skinner on a Question Time, he's going, about these Gurkhas. He said, yeah, they're like ninjas. Or as he say, they're like ninjas. They are. You've got a funny voice, isn't it? They're like ninjas and they're like all this, all their, like, all of, yeah, it's because of that old martial art, the martial, not arts, but martial race. But you look it up on Wikipedia, it says what they were really was a bit dumb. And that's why I was loyal, because they're a bit dumb. And this is what Wikipedia says. I think it's dumb, sometimes. And that's why they had them. Because there's sort of mountain people, rather than the lower landers that might have been thinking a bit more and a bit, could be a bit traitorous, like. So they praised up the not going to say dummy, but the Gurkha, they praised them up, built them up, bit of spin. Now, how do we know that Frank Skinner isn't getting all that spin that's come down for the ages? Or any other soldier or anything like that? What are the real battle stories? I mean, are there real medals today? I mean, I don't know what, I mean, are they making the medal stories up? It's, you know, it's turned out a bit iffy, isn't it, at the moment? It's in the press. Some people be making up stories about their heroic deeds. So, I don't know. What is a soldier, after all? A worker for powers that think, really, isn't it? So, oh my God, the sun's come out. Look, everybody, the sun's come out.